Hello and welcome back. I have a question for you. What does this?
Wir sind entschlossen, unser Leben mit allen Mitteln zu verteidigen, ohne Rücksicht darauf, ob die uns umgebende Welt die Notwendigkeit dieses Kampfes einsieht oder nicht. Der totale Krieg ist also das Gebot der Stunde. Die Gefahr, vor der wir stehen, ist riesengroß. Riesengroß müssen deshalb auch die Anstrengungen sein, mit denen wir entgegentreten. Es ist also jetzt die Stunde gekommen, die Glacé-Handschuhe auszuziehen.
Have to do with this. And what does this? Have to do with this. Does it feel like a far stretch to go from war and fascism to entertainment, music and dancing? For the German philosopher Theodor Adorno, these phenomena are intrinsically linked. In this video, we will explore this link. Adorno was born in 1903. He witnessed the uprise of Nazism in Germany and fascism in Europe. In 1934, he left Germany after being expelled by the Nazis from his teaching job at the university. He went to England and to the US. The US made quite the impression on him. What he witnessed there was the uprise of mass entertainment, or what he would call the culture industry. The way the culture industry seemed to work reminded him an awful lot of how Nazism and fascism seemed to work. The flashing billboards on Times Square. Broadway entertainment and pop music demand the same from us as totalitarianism, namely the uncritical and cheerful acceptance of authority. Authority that tells us to hate and kill, and authority that tells us to spend money on things we don't really need. And for Adorno, the psychological mechanisms that make us wage war and enjoy entertainment are essentially the same. And this means that as long as we surrender to entertainment, the dangers of totalitarianism are real. So, why are psychological mechanisms that lead to war the same as those that make us enjoy entertainment? Let's have a closer look at this mechanism.
And dit liedje kennen jullie natuurlijk allemaal. Dus ook voor de luisteraars thuis, of je nou in de keuken staat of in de woonkamer, in de living. Zing maar mee van waar je ook bent. Misschien in de auto en het hele plein wil ik horen.
Zet die oorlog nu stop en een generaal aan de horizon. Kijk omhoog naar een wonderen regenboog. 10.000 luchtballonnen kleuren de hemel blauw. 10.000 luchtballonnen zijn op weg naar jou. 10.000 luchtballonnen kleuren de horizon. 10.000 jaren oorlog zonder dat ooit iemand.
Zo. We saw a trio of women singing a nice children's song. Nothing wrong with that, right? Sure, it's true that these children's songs are produced in such a way that children like them. And that's why most children's songs kind of sound the same. They all have a duration of around 3 minutes, and they all have more or less the same structure. There's a musical introduction, then there's a verse, then a chorus. We rinse and repeat that structure a couple of times, and bum, there's your song. Children, like those in the video clip, love these songs. They sing along with them, dance to them, and make their parents buy CDs. Now, there's nothing really wrong with that, right? I think Adorno would probably agree. This is all pretty appropriate for children. However, and here comes the catch, what if we, the adults, never grew up? What if we remain childlike when it comes to listening to music? What if the music produced by the culture industry appeals to us in the same way a children's song appeals to children? Are we adult infants when it comes to enjoying entertainment and music? And remember what we started with. Are we adult infants when it comes to war? Adorno would definitely say yes. We as adults seem to be oblivious to the fact that our tastes are underdeveloped, simple and predictable. And this underdevelopment and predictability is used by the culture industry to sell us adult versions of children's songs and childlike entertainment. Or as Adorno puts it, the listener, that's us, is converted, we are being influenced or manipulated, along his line of least resistance. This manipulation exploits our childlike preferences, into the acquiescent purchasers. We are made into zombies that buy stuff. What Adorno is saying is that the culture industry wants to sell us stuff. Music, entertainment, iPods, fancy t-shirts with a print of our favorite band, and so on and so forth. And the industry exploits our underdeveloped childlike preferences to achieve this. Just think about it. It aren't only children's songs that have a duration of around 3 minutes. Most pop tunes are also around 3 minutes. Not too long, so a minimum of our attention leads to a maximum result. In addition, according to Adorno, the melody and harmony of pop music are completely predictable, so the least effort is required from us as listeners. The melody has to be catchy, so we immediately like it, just like children immediately love the melody of a children's song. And for our convenience, the melody is repeated over and over and over again. And this is true for children's songs as well as for pop tunes. So in short, according to Adorno, a minimal effort required from the listener may lead to maximal satisfaction of that listener. A simple trick to micromanage us into buying anything and everything that is offered to us by the culture industry. Now, let's look at this clip where Adorno talks about entertainment and pop music.
Thank you. glaube allerdings, dass Versuche politischen Protest mit der Popular Music, also mit der Unterhaltungsmusik, zusammenzubringen, deshalb zum Scheitern verurteilt sind, weil die ganze Sphäre der Unterhaltungsmusik, auch wo sie irgendwie modernistisch sich aufputzt, so mit dem wahren Charakter, mit dem Amüsement, mit dem Schielen nach dem Konsum verbunden ist, dass also Versuche, dem eine veränderte Funktion zu geben, ganz äußerlich bleiben. Und ich muss sagen, wenn also dann irgendjemand sich hinstellt und auf eine im Grunde doch schnulzenhafte Musik dann irgendwelche Dinge darüber singt, dass Vietnam nicht zu ertragen sei, dann finde ich, dass gerade dieser Song nicht zu ertragen ist, weil er, indem er das Entsetzliche noch irgendwie konsumierbar macht, schließlich auch daraus noch etwas wie Konsumqualitäten herauspresst.
Adorno is saying two things. First of all, he says that pop music is so aimed at the immediate gratification of our simple preferences that any other goal, such as political protest, is simply impossible. Think, for example, about U2's song Bloody Sunday. So when we hear that tune, do we really think about the events of 1972 in Ireland, where soldiers shot unarmed protesters? According to Adorno, most of us just like the tune. So how can music be a form of protest if we only like it because it sounds nice? And second of all, and perhaps even worse, is that pop music isn't only unable to function as a form of protest. According to Adorno, it actually finds a way to exploit the misery of war. It makes out of the war a sort of consumable product. Here we have another opportunity to sing, sell records and sell concert tickets. And nothing sells as well as singing about the horrors of war, all the innocent babies and world peace. So what Adorno is telling us is that when we give in to our childlike, underdeveloped preferences, we are basically doomed. There's a whole industry out there that exploits these preferences, selling us things we don't really need. But it gets even worse. Our relentless need to satisfy our simple preferences makes us gullible. Just like the culture industry encourages us to remain underdeveloped when it comes to tastes, political leaders encourage us to remain underdeveloped when it comes to our mind. And here also, our underdeveloped preferences are exploited. So we, the Nazis or any other totalitarian regime, we are good. And they, so the foreigners, Jews, Arabs, they are bad. So these politicians don't sell us music or entertainment. They sell us simple solutions. Simple solutions that do not solve any real problem, but they keep us quiet and satisfied, just like music and entertainment do. And there you have it. Our urge to satisfy our underdeveloped preferences leads to bad music, perverse consumption, and arguably also to horrible wars. Now, Adorno paints a pretty gloomy picture of music and totalitarianism in society. But do you agree with him? I'm very curious to read your responses. For now, I wish you all the best and I hope to see you next time. Bye!